loop components are very popular. But whenever I show people editing loop components together, first there is excitement, but immediately a question comes. How can anybody change anybody else's data? Where is the accountability? Do we have anything like track changes? Otherwise, however convenient it is, it just doesn't make sense. So that is what this video is about. Here is an example. This is a question and answer or Q&A loop component in a mail. One person has sent the mail, that's Nitin on the right side, and multiple people have submitted the reply. Now it is Nitin editing something which is written by assistant. So I'm just changing 284 to 300. That should not be allowed. Who has written this originally? Assistant. Now, how someone else is editing it? What is the accountability? It's very simple. All that you have to do is go to any part of the loop component, click inside the text, and you will see another icon coming up, the same profile photo. But when you click on it, it actually tells you the date time stamp. That's track changes. And now when I click here, it's telling me that Nitin changed it just now. Let's scroll down and look at this one. Click on any word. And yes, this has been written by sales a couple of days back. But now notice what I'm doing. I'm going to change it to. Now let's see what happens. This one is still answered by sales, but notice there's a plus one now. When I say plus one, it's even highlighting which part was written by sales. And when I say Nitin, it's highlighting that part. Amazing kind of track changes. Now, if you just want to see the status of a snapshot, then you can also have version history. You open the loop component, just click on the title there. It will open it on browser. There will be name of the loop component written here. Open that, go to version history. So let's see. Now, this was the state of affairs at that point of time. Even now, it's the same thing works. You can see snapshot as well as who changed what when. So don't worry. Loop components is a revolutionary way of working together. Use it to your advantage. Track changes is very much there. If you're new to loop components, I have a video just created about loop components. Have a look at that. I also published a video specifically about Outlook Q&A. Have a look at that as well. That's it for now. Thank you.